Hello everyone and welcome to a Overtool GUI tutorial and some Overwatch Overtool news for the new update and stuff. So with the summer games you need to update your Overtool. I'll put the link in the description. After you do that, if it doesn't work, you can try just making a new map entirely and just copying everything in. So then you can also download the updated Overtool GUI. Your name updated it a bit and also fixed the thing with that was in the old one where you couldn't export hero voice lines. So if we just compare the two, you can see this is the old one and this is the new one. You can see that there's the direct command prompt output in the middle of the screen, while here there is no command. You can just display recent command output and stuff. So with the other things, I think it's quite similar. You still have to set your Overwatch Live and Overwatch BTR the directories. But you'll only need to use the Overwatch Live because there is no Overtool for Overwatch BTR currently. And you can set the output path. So something I'm adding before I edit the video, because I forgot to say it in the main thing. You should... it's recommended and you should back up your Overwatch current, like the summer games and the Overtool. So if they decide to push the BTR to live, you will still be able to export stuff because there currently isn't an Overtool for the BTR or the 1.14 version, which is the BTR. So just copy your Overwatch into a map like Overwatch Backup or something, where you'll be keeping old Overwatch versions or something. So yeah, just a quick note, and yeah. Looking at the things, he also added a tool to convert DDS to PNG, which is for textures. And there's still a vent to OGG for audio. Here you can just list stuff like game types and it'll just list them for you. And then you can export stuff. So if there's a no after the loot boxes, for example, you need to add an you'll need to set an output path, and there's if it's a star, you'll need there's an optional argument that you can use to export a specific hero or a map or something. So if you use Sombra for now for the test, I want the voice. So I'll just click that and it will do work its magic, I guess. So you just have to wait for it to finish. In the meantime, I can open the map, and when it's done, it will just show you the command prompt which you can close. Looking at the test, Sombra exported correctly. There's also voice lines for the new skin, and just all of the voice lines, but you can still convert everything, so there will be no WAN files which you can't open if you don't. Yeah, I guess OGG files I open with VLC media player. Currently it's converting everything, so we'll be able to listen to it later. Okay, I guess. Yeah, I think I have to wait for it to finish. So, what's up with the PTR? Why can't we export it? They changed the I guess the STUs. I don't really know about the stuff that they broke with the PTR. I don't really want to know. It's complicated. So I just stick to my own stuff. We can listen to them. Sounds like a widow mine. So yeah, I think that's gonna be it for the the tutorial. If you have any questions, comment down below and I'll try to answer them as fast as I can. If you're new to the channel, make sure to subscribe and like the video if you liked, and I'll see you in the next one. Bye.